If human beings ever inhabit another world in our solar system, Mars is the most likely candidate. It is the planet which is half the diameter of the Earth and have the same amount of dry land area compared to Earth. Mars and Earth are very different planets when it comes to temperature, size, and atmosphere. But geologic processes on the two planets are surprisingly similar. On Mars, we see volcanoes, canyons, and impact basins much like the ones we see on Earth. To find out everything in detail, in 2027, we are going to colonize Mars. And this mission is known as Mars 1. Mars 1 is a non-profit organization based in Netherlands that has proposed to land the first humans on Mars and establish a permanent human colony there by 2027. The private spaceflight project is led by Dutch entrepreneur Bas Lansdorp, who announced the Mars 1 project in May 2012. He is best known as the co-founder and CEO of Mars 1. He worked for 5 years at Delft University of Technology and in 2008 founded Ampix Power in order to develop a new viable method of generating wind energy. The total budget of the project is $6 billion and the money is collected from various sources such as investments, reality TV sponsors, donations, merchandise, and crowdfunding campaigns. Bas Lansdorp also invested his personal wealth for this project. In 2011, he sold part of his shares in Ampix in order to launch Mars 1. Until 2013, he financed almost the entire project by himself. It is a one-way journey to Mars where people who are going will never come back to Earth. In the first year, 4 people will be sent and every 2 years, new 4 people will be sent. Considering the fact of leaving the Earth forever, still, more than 200,000 people applied from all over the world. Out of 200,000 people, only 660 were selected for round 3, from which 100 candidates, 50 men and 50 women, are selected. Out of these 100, 6 groups of 4 people will be formed and trained for the mission. The number of people in group is kept 4 because 4 is the smallest possible group size. Working with a larger group will increase the cost and the complexity of reaching to Mars. If any single member from the 4 people changes his or her mind about the mission, then the whole group will leave the mission or will be trained from the start with the new member. The big question is why we are going to Mars? Well, Mars has many Earth-like similarities where one day is equal to 24 hours and 36 minutes. Furthermore, human settlement on Mars will aid the understanding of origins of solar system, origins of life, and human's place in the universe. A second reason is good old-fashioned curiosity: where did Mars come from? Can it teach us about Earth's history? Is there life on Mars? These are just some of the burning questions for scientists all over the world. Also, the mission will jumpstart massive developments in all kinds of areas. For example, in recycling, solar energy, food production, and the advancement of medical technology. Roadmap for the mission. After the crew selection and training of the crew, in 2020, a demonstration and communication satellite will be launched. Communication satellite will be placed into a stationary orbit of Mars. This communication satellite enables 24/7 communication between the two planets and can also relay images, videos, and other data from the Mars's surface. Following that, in 2022, one intelligent rover and one trailer will be launched. On Mars, the rover will drive around to find the best location for the settlement of humans. According to study, an ideal location will be far enough north where the soil contains enough water, receive maximum sunlight, and flat enough for the construction of the settlement. Then in 2024, 6 cargoes are transported to Mars in order to create space for arrival of humans, which will be departed in a group of 4 in 2026 and will land on Mars in 2027. After that, every 2 years, new crew will be sent to Mars. As it is the one-way journey to Mars, it also means saying goodbye to Earth, family and friends forever. During the training, astronauts' mobility will be restricted for a long period of time and they will not be able to speak friends and family face to face on Earth. The only way of communication from Mars will be through satellites, which is limited to the speed of light, and depending upon the orbit of Mars and Earth, will have a delay up to 20 minutes. If they feel homesick, they will receive psychological assistance from Earth. The mission is made one-way mission because so far we don't have the technology to take off from Mars. And it reduces the cost and complete infrastructure of the mission. Also, we don't know how it feels to be in complete gravity when you spend huge amount of time in zero gravity. The trip will go through various gravities to Mars, which has a gravity of 1/3 to Earth. NASA has said by 2030 it will figure out the technology to bring the astronauts back. Many of us might think that it will be a fun trip to Mars, as we see in all sci-fi movies. But it will not. It will be arduous and the astronauts will spend a lot of time in a very small room during the 7 months need to be safe from solar radiation, as there is no atmosphere. The shape of the spacecraft will save them from maximum solar wind or radiation. They will face solar wind every 2 months during the journey. They will have to eat frozen and dried food and no shower, only wet toilets. And in addition to that, a constant noise from the machinery of the spacecraft like ventilators and computers. They will have to work out 3 hours a day to keep muscle mass. Even before they arrive on Mars, the life support units will be there to support for the basic needs. The life support units will create water through heating of ice in soil. As the soil is heated and the water condenses, a portion of water will be stored while the another is used to produce oxygen. About 80% of what we breathe on Earth is nitrogen. So nitrogen and argon gas will be extracted from the atmosphere of Mars and together with oxygen will be injected into the living areas via a tube. Once they arrive on Mars, the astronauts will begin using their relatively spacious living units, over 50 meters square per person and a total of more than 200 meters square combined interior space. Within the settlement are inflatable components which contain bedrooms, working areas, a living room, and a plant production unit, where they will grow greenery. They will also be able to shower as normal, prepare fresh food in the kitchen, wear regular clothes, and in essence lead a typical day-to-day life. After that, they will work on construction, maintenance, and research. If the astronauts leave the settlement, they have to wear Mars suit. The Mars suit will be flexible enough to allow the astronauts to work with both cumbersome construction materials and sophisticated machinery, and at the same time keep them safe from the harsh solar radiation. Two crew members will be proficient in use and repair of all equipment to the extent that they can identify and solve all technical problems. In addition, two crew members will be expert in extensive medical training in order to treat minor, major, and critical health problems. At least one person will study the geology of Mars and the remaining person will study exobiology, which is the study of biology of alien life. considering the costing and feasibility of the project, Mars One has received huge amount of criticism from astronauts and aerospace industry. A similar project study estimated by NASA cost $100 billion, but it included bringing the astronauts back to Earth. The criticism is Mars One has no spacecraft and rocket in development and have not shared any research on the effects of microgravity on humans in flight and in reduced gravity on the surface of Mars. Many astronauts are saying the probability of reaching Mars alive is only 30% and that of surviving there more than 3 months is less than 20%. Looking at history, it's very common that great ideas or out-of-the-box thinking always receive huge criticism. But even after receiving so much criticism, Mars One believes all the problem will be solved, especially regarding the funding of the project. If the mission succeeds, it will be a historic win for mankind and will be the greatest adventure humans can ever do. If you believe in what Mars One believes, be a part of this great adventure.